Assalamu alaikum, and thank you for joining us for today's episode. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in about 110 ayahs about ibadat, worships, while He subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned over 1,500 ayahs that talks about akhlaq, moral ethics and conduct. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Ma min shay'in athqalu fil mizan min husn al-khuluq." There is nothing that weighs heavier in the scale than good morals. For this reason, we chose this Ramadan, 30 characters of a Muslim. 30 characters and qualities a Muslim should have and implement in his daily life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us what is beneficial to us and to benefit us from what we are taught. We would like to thank our sponsors for today's episode, Al-Manasik, your Hajj and Umrah companion, Mudaffa, your one-stop shop for Islamic essentials, shipping conveniently from Dallas, Texas, and Halab Pastry USA for all your Mediterranean sweets and pastries. Please do not forget to click on the link below to send your answers for today's episode or visit dalilo.com. Wassalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. Inshallah, you are all having a blessed Ramadan. You know, one thing I think that this past year has taught us, that our experience with the pandemic and everything else that's happened, it has taught us the quality of humility, at-tawadu', to recognize the reality of ourselves, of this world, and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to realize that we are the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is really in control. That we see what happened, that an entire world comes screeching to a halt. It's in many ways brought to its knees by something, by a virus that we can't even see with our own eyes. And this is a reminder, a very stark reminder, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has full power, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is in control, that no matter how much we progress, no matter how technologically advanced we become, no matter how much wealth that we have, no matter how much status or privilege that we have, that it reminds us of our reality. And that should humble us. Not in a way that makes us look down at ourselves or that doesn't allow us to have confidence or honor or izzah, but in a way that allows us to walk humbly on the earth, to deal in humility with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, our sustainer, our provider, our protector, and to be humble with our brothers and sisters in faith. That, and in humanity as well. That's the idea of at-tawadu', humility. It's a quality, it's a characteristic that doesn't mean to lower oneself, but it means to deal with others in a way of kindness, mercy, in some cases softness as well, to recognize that that is how we are as believers, humble, and to avoid that evil and the disease of arrogance that can plague our hearts if we start to think so much in the I form. I did this. It's because of me that I have this wealth. It's because of my work that I'm in the position that I'm in. It's because of who I am that I even have this religious status or position, or I'm doing all this. To start with the I is a way to invite that arrogance and that whisper and that impact of shaitan. But to recognize first and foremost that all of this comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we put in the work. Yes, we put in the effort. But who gave us the strength, who gave us the ability, who gave us the tawfiq, the facilitation for us to be able to do this. And so that's where humility comes in. It's to attribute and to associate everything first and foremost with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His blessings on us. And as a result of that, to deal with others in a way that is humble and that is recognizing their position and their honor and their status as well. And that's why Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah, He said that humbleness and to have humility, tawadu, is to leave from your home and to not meet a believer except that you see that he or she has a right and has a favor over you and to treat them as such. To look at someone who's older and recognize this person has probably had a much longer time to do so much more good than I have. To look at someone who's younger than you and to say, this person may be younger, but they've had such less time to commit sins like I have. And so we deal with others with that humility. We deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that humility. We recognize where we came from. We recognize where we're going. And that allows us to rid our hearts of that arrogance and to have that humbleness, that humility, that tawadu. And this is a quality that actually raises us. We think arrogance, or we think dealing with people in a certain way, is what's going to give us status. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, "Man tawadha'a lillah, rafa'ahu Allah." Whoever lowers themselves, meaning whoever is who is humble, whoever shows that humility, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise them. And the first quality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes his beloved believers as, ibadur rahman, the servants of the most merciful, he says, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا, that the servants of the most merciful are the ones who walk with humility on the earth. And so this is a quality that we try to develop, that we try to have this humbleness to rid ourselves of this arrogance. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example of living humility with honor, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so two quick questions, since we're looking at the Qur'an in this month of the Qur'an, that verse that I just mentioned, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ, what surah is that set of verses in? That's number one. Number two is another surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the man with the two gardens, talking to us also about the idea of arrogance and protecting ourselves from that arrogance. What surah is that in? And this is another reminder, 18 different projects, 18 opportunities to earn Jannah, to earn the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please make sure that you donate, that you give whatever you can in this blessed month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and your family. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakumullah khair for listening. Please click on the link below or visit thelittle.com to submit your answers. And please share with your friends and family, because we will not be doing our drawings till tomorrow to give more people the opportunity to submit their answers. We're also helping 18 masjids construction and expansion projects during this blessed month of Ramadan. And what a better sadaqah to give than a perpetual one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with this opportunity not to give a perpetual charity for one project, but for 18 projects here in the United States. We urge everyone to donate as little as possible if they can. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tahqaranna min al-ma'ruf shay'an." Do not belittle any good deed. We believe if plenty of us donated a small amount, we will be able, inshallah, to help complete every single construction and expansion projects for Islamic centers as well as Islamic schools here in the United States. We're working very diligently this Ramadan, inshallah, to get as many brothers and sisters as possible to donate $10 a month. So please click on the link below, thelittle.com/strongertogether, and join us on this campaign. Jazakumullah khair, and we'll see you in tomorrow's episode. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.